gather your people, O Lord. Gather your people, O Lord. One bread, one body, one spirit of love. Gather your people, O Lord. Draw us forth to the table of life, brothers and sisters, each of us called to walk you in your light. Gather your people, O Lord. Gather your people, O Lord. One bread, one body, one spirit of love. Gather your people, O Lord. Draw your parts of the body of Christ, needing each other, each of us gives the Spirit provides. Gather your people, O Lord. Gather your people, O Lord. One bread, one body, one spirit of love. Gather your people, O Lord. No more harm on the mountain of God. Sword into plowshare. Free us, O Lord, from hardness of heart. Gather your people, O Lord. Gather your people, O Lord. One bread, one body, one spirit of love. Gather your people, O Lord.
In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, amen. The grace and peace of the risen Jesus be with all of you.
With your spirit.
Oh, beautiful morning, right? Give a greeting to those near you. And to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery, Lord, we reflect on our failings against each other, against you. You were sent to heal the contrite. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy upon us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, glory to God. to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who govern all things in heaven and on earth, hear the pleading of your people. Bestow your peace on our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, we ask, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Seven centuries before Jesus, the Hebrews had a shrine called a temple in this passage at Shiloh. At this shrine was the Ark of the Covenant, a wooden chest, overlaid with gold, holding the stone of the Ten Commandments. Eli was the highest high priest at the shrine. His young assistant was Samuel. God calls the youngster to be a prophet. A reading from the first book of Samuel. Samuel was sleeping in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was. The Lord called to Samuel, who answered, "Here I am." Samuel ran to Eli and said, "Here I am. You called me." "I did not call you," Eli said. "Go back to sleep." So he went back to sleep. Again, the Lord called Samuel, who rose and went to Eli. "Here I am," he said. "You called me." But Eli answered, "I did not call you, my son. Go back to sleep." At that time, Samuel was not familiar with the Lord, because the Lord had not revealed anything to him as yet. The Lord called Samuel again for the third time. Getting up and going to Eli, he said, "Here I am. You called me." Then Eli understood that the Lord was calling the youth. So he said to Samuel, "Go to sleep, and if you are called, reply. Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening." When Samuel went to sleep in his place, the Lord came and revealed his presence, called out as before, "Samuel, Samuel." Samuel answered, "Speak, for your servant is listening." Samuel grew up, and the Lord was with him, not permitting any word of his to be without effect. The word of the Lord.
Here am I, Lord, I come to do your will. Here am I, Lord, I come to do your will. I have waited for the Lord. stooped toward me and heard my cry. And he put a new song into my mouth, a hymn to our God. Here am I, Lord, I come to do your will. Sacrifice or offering you wish not, but ears open to obedience you gave me. Holocaust and sufferings you sought not. Then said I, behold, I come. Here am I, Lord, I come to do your will. In the written scroll, it is prescribed for me to do your will, O my God, is my delight. And your law is written in my heart. Here am I, Lord, I come to do your will. I announced your justice in the vast assembly. I did not restrain my lips, as you, O Lord, know. Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
Corinth, a port city in ancient Greece, was noted for its immorality. Anything was permissible. Paul counters this attitude, not by putting down the human body, but as evil, but just the opposite. It's a temple of God. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the body is not for immorality, but for the Lord, and the Lord is for the body. God raised the Lord and will also raise us by his power. Do you not know that your bodies are members of Christ? But whoever is joined to the Lord becomes one spirit with him. Avoid immorality. Every other sin a person commits is outside the body, but the immoral person sins against his own body. Do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, whom you have from God, and that you are not your own? For you have been purchased at a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
with you. A reading now of the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, Lord.
John the Baptist was standing with two disciples. As he watched Jesus walk by, John said, "Behold, the Lamb of God." The two disciples heard what John said. They followed Jesus. Jesus turned around and saw them following, and he said, "What are you looking for?" And they said, "Rabbi, teacher, where are you staying?" He said, "Come, you'll see." They went and saw where Jesus was staying. They stayed with him that day. It was about 4 in the afternoon. Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, was one of the two who heard John and followed Jesus. He first found his own brother, Simon, told him, "We have found the Messiah, Christ." Then he brought his brother to Jesus. Jesus looked at Simon and said, "You, Simon, son of John, will be called Cephas, Peter." The Gospel of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
In the book of Samuel, we're told about a woman named Hannah. She had no children, and she suffered bitterly because of this. She went to visit the sanctuary with her husband at Shiloh. It's in the hill country north of Jerusalem. And there she poured out her troubles to God, praying for a child. And she promised God, if she had a boy, she would give him back to God. The priest at the sanctuary was Eli. He was the caretaker of the Ark of the Covenant, and he was sitting at the entrance of the tent watching Hannah as she mumbled and was weeping. He thought she must be drunk and mumbling to herself like that. "No," she said, "it's too early in the day to be drunk." Then she shared with Eli her troubles. Eli simply told her to go home. God would hear her prayer. She was comforted by this and went home. And sure enough, she had a son. And when Samuel was 5 or 6 years old, she did bring him back to the sanctuary at Shiloh, and she left him there to live with Eli, the priest's family. She gave him back to God. I mean, hearing a story like that, we say, well, that sounds kind of awful. Wanting a child, having a child, and, you know, giving them back to God. That's why here at the church, especially at Easter and Christmas, when we have a bigger crowd than today, of course, but the kids go downstairs at one point, and they have Easter egg hunts and a party of cake for Jesus at Christmas. And we always try to remember to tell the parents, be sure to pick up your kid. This is a no church left child left behind church. Thinking about Eli and Samuel. After the birth of Samuel, Hannah was blessed with 5 more children. So I guess she was rejoicing, even though she had given up 1. Samuel was raised there. He was educated in the service of God. When Eli, older now, arthritic, losing his sight, losing his hearing, Samuel was his right hand. And he was the one who kept an eye on the oil lamp that burned before the Ark of the Covenant. He even slept before the Ark. Sometimes We get a call from God that changes our life, or we are called to do something. Sometimes we pick up on it. Sometimes we don't. It just slides away. Samuel, we heard how he got his special call once he was living there at the sanctuary. It was to become a prophet, and indeed he did. He becomes the priest and the prophet of Israel and did marvelous, marvelous things. He led his countrymen into battles and won them. He established the monarchy for Israel, and he anointed David, and the next king the first king, Saul, and then David, as the first two kings of Israel. In the gospel, Andrew and another disciple, they saw John point to Jesus and say, "Behold, the Lamb of God." That's a code word, Lamb of God, the one that will be offered for God. And they followed Jesus, just left John. And Jesus notices, "What do you want? A rabbi, teacher, where are you staying?" They wanted to learn from him. And it was about 4 p.m, it said. And they probably stayed the night and shared a meal with Jesus, that first meeting with him. And the food there was probably better than they would have gotten with John the Baptist. He was eating locusts and things that he would find in the desert. But Jesus doesn't say anything about him eating that way. And he probably they stayed the night there with Jesus and listened to him teach. And then the next day, Andrew quickly tells his brother, Simon, "We have found the Messiah, the Christ, the Anointed One." And he brought his brother to Jesus. And Jesus takes one look at him and said, "You will be Cephas," meaning Peter, the rock. And on this rock of Peter, that's the one he's going to build his church. So he's collecting his disciples. Their call was not as dramatic as that Samuel got in the middle of the night, the three-time call. But God does call. He does speak to us. Sometimes we hear him. Sometimes not so much. Oftentimes, we pick up on the message through somebody else, maybe a family member or a friend, or maybe an event like the Mass we're celebrating right now, different parts of it calling us to something. There are many, many attention grabbers, TVs and Facebooks and phones, and oftentimes God is put on hold. If we want to hear the Lord, we have to put the other voices on hold so that God can get through to us. If you set a time and a place for quiet prayer, it might happen. If we don't schedule it in, we're scheduling it out. We have to make time for the Lord if we want to hear him and hear what he's saying to us. If we don't, we won't hear. The boy Samuel got his guidance, especially from the priest Eli, in recognizing God's special call to be the prophet, the next priest, and the disciples, at least those couple here, received their guidance from John the Baptist to recognize Jesus as the Lamb of God. So, listen to your call. At certain times, God will be speaking to you, and set aside some time or ask other people about what you think God is telling you or speaking to you about. We ask sometimes, what does God want? And there's probably somebody who can help us with that, who can interpret. And even during the Mass itself, look and listen So the scripture of the day, the songs that are sung, they're chosen for a reason to fit the theme of the day. So maybe some of the prayers written for the theme also, or just going to communion and receiving the fullness of God in the sacrament of the Eucharist. With young Samuel, listen to the voice of God. See what he's trying to tell you to do. And thank you for coming out this morning, viciously cold and such. We have some water pipes froze up in the basement, first time that's ever happened here. And we'll have to figure out how to warm those babies up. We don't even know where the pipes are. Today in the lobby, there's a bake sale. This is a fundraiser for an Eagle project. They're going to build picnic tables for the back of the church. It's the project of Anana Rose, and she is a lot of bakery back there for sale, trying to raise money to buy the wood and supplies and things. So maybe you can help her out. There's a little table next to it. It's to get your tickets if you want to attend the Valentine dinner night here. There's more details about it in the bulletin today. And then the diocese may be giving some of you a call. If you give money donations to the diocese, like the Catholic Appeal or other occasions, and you do it with your credit card or something online, they are changing their giving platform. And they're going to call everybody who they have a name who's doing that occasionally, and to tell them that there's a different place. It's not a scam. It's not a fraud. Some might think that somebody else is trying to cut in to get the diocese's money. So there's a note in the bulletin today about it, and you can initiate the call. It tells you how to do that, or you can wait for it, and when it does occur, we just try to remember it. It's legitimate. Let's stand now. Let's profess the faith. I believe in God, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, communion of saints, forgiveness of sin, resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let's offer now these prayer petitions.
Lord Jesus, comfort the dying, heal our sick, strengthen those having surgery, bless those who care for them.
We pray to the Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, help the people suffering in countries at war, bring them peace.
We pray to the Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, in our words and actions, help us inspire those around us to see you, the Lamb of God, as their Savior.
We pray to the Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, we pray for those struggling against addictions. Give them courage.
We pray to the Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, we pray for leaders of nations. May they listen to the needs of their people and respond the best they can.
We pray to the Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, comfort those who work in winter storms and cold.
We pray to the Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, in this Mass, we pray for Pat Goggins, along with those we love, and our personal petitions.
We pray to the Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, receive us this morning again with all of our prayer needs and petitions, those we have voiced here and those in our hearts. Bless and favor us now with the grace and the gift of Jesus in this Eucharist. He lives among us forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
Will you come and follow me if I but call your name? Will you come and
everybody be thanked
now and never be the same? Will you let my love be shown? Will you let my name be known? Will you let my life be grown in you and you in me? Will you leave yourself behind if I but call your name? Will you care for cruel and kind and never be the same? Will you resist the hostile stare? Should your life attract or scare? Will you let me answer prayer in you and you in me?
Alrighty, thank you. Pray now that this sacrifice be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant us, O Lord, that we may participate worthily in this mystery, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is being accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is right and just.
Truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always, everywhere, to give you thanks, Holy Father, eternal God, through Jesus Christ. By his birth, he brought renewal to our fallen state. By his suffering, canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he opened the way to eternal life. By ascending to you, Father, he unlocked the gates of heaven. And so, in the company of angels and saints, we praise you without end, we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he comes in the name of
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy these gifts, we pray. Send down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took some bread. Giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to the disciples. Take this, all of you, eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when the supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice. Giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples. Take this, all of you, drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you, for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come again.
We celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Heavenly Father, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation. Giving thanks, you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray, partaking of the body and blood of Jesus Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with our Pope, our Bishop, the clergy, and all the people Christ has gained for himself. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her spouse, the glorious martyrs, the blessed apostles, our patron Bernard, and all the saints who have pleased you through the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
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 Good morning, boys and girls. What did you color today? Okay. Oh, good. Good. The Lamb of God. Right there. Okay. Hang on to those. You want to take them along. Okay. Yeah, I want to see yours, too. All right. Pretty good. That's who you are. And this is Jesus, the Lamb. Good. Thanks for coming and making these things. Some stay at home. It's too cold today. Let's say the prayer of Jesus. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus, who said to the apostles, I leave you peace, and peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Grant us peace and joy in your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Jesus be with all of you. Amen. Go wish him a sign of peace.
Take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will wend my heart for them? Whom shall I send? Is it I am, Lord? Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will know, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of snow and rain, I have worn my people's pain. I I will break their hearts of stone. Give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go. The Lord of wind and flame, I will tend the poor and lame. I will set a feast for them. My hand will save. Finest gift I will provide. Till their hearts be satisfied, I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send? Is it Lord? Is it I, Lord? I heard you. Blessed are the poor in spirit, longing for their Lord. For the coming kingdom they'll be there. Blessed are the sorrowing, for they shall be consoled. And the meek shall come to rule the world. Lead me, Lord, lead me, Lord, by the light of truth. Blessed are the merciful, for mercy shall be theirs, and the pure in heart shall see their God. Blessed are they whose hunger only holiness can seek and to find the narrow way. Be my way, be my truth, be my life, my Lord, and lead me, Lord, today. Blessed are those who through their lifetime sow the seeds of peace. All will call them children of the Lord. Blessed are you, though persecuted in your holy life, for in heaven great is your reward. Lead me, Lord, lead me, Lord, by the light of truth, to seek and to find the narrow
pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love. In your kindness, make those you have nourished with the Eucharist one in mind and heart. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go with the joy of the Lord. Pray strongly against this cold wave. We have donuts in the basement hall. Let us go now with the joy of the Lord.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, longing for their Lord, for God's coming kingdom shall be theirs. Blessed are they who sorrowing, for they shall be consoled, and the meek shall come to rule the world. Lead me, Lord.